Raise your hand if you skip breakfast sometime this week. Thank you. Did you know that skipping breakfast increases your risk for obesity by 4.5 times, according to Minsky 2005? Today I'm going to tell you why it is important to have healthy eating habits, especially while in college. We all have to eat to survive, so this affects every one of us. If you follow the healthy eating behaviors that I will tell you, you will improve your overall health and lower your risk for serious illness or even smaller illnesses as well. I'm going to outline poor eating habits, how they affect you, and what you can do to change in the future. The first habit that I want to address is skipping meals. Like we talked about, breakfast is a common meal to skip, and it's actually the worst meal to skip because it slows down your metabolism for the rest of the day. But for those of you who do eat breakfast in the morning, you can still fall under other common pitfalls, such as nutritional imbalances. Did you know that the recommended amount of fruits and vegetables is 5 servings a day, but that the average college student has less than 1 serving a day? According to Oregon State University in 2011, their study said that college males had approximately 5 servings in a week as versus just a day, and females had just a little bit less of only 4 servings in a week. Their study also found that more than 30% of our calories in college student diets come from fat, which is above what we're supposed to be having. Other habits that are harmful besides just specific food habits are eating disorders such as anorexia nervosa, bulimia nervosa, and binge eating. Binge eating occurs when you eat large amounts of food in a short period of time. It's usually done in secret, and people who do this do it frequently. This often leads to weight gain, which is upsetting to them, yet to overcome this, they often turn to food. So it's a vicious cycle, according to the University of Alabama, 2011. Weight gain is one harmful effect, which leads me to my next topic of talking about the harmful effects that these habits can have on you. So the harmful effects, there's long-term as well as emotional and mental health. For long-term, University of Alabama at Birmingham 2010 again says that eating disorders can lead to long-term health problems and even death. Other long-term health problems include cancer, heart disease, weight gain, and other things such as that, according to Black 2010. There are also emotional and mental health problems that occur, such as lower grades and less retention in school and whatnot. You can also have a lot of feelings of guilt and feeling like you've lost control, according to Rinder 2010. Next slide, please. So, in order to overcome some of these difficulties, you need to practice healthy eating habits. It includes both making good food choices as well as eliminating stress, which affects your eating patterns and whatnot. So, to change food choices, you need to limit fast food and junk food. Drink plenty of water, eat balanced meals, eating, correct amounts in the different categories, and carrying healthy snacks with you, such as fruit, veggies, or nuts, so that when you get hungry, you don't just go for, a Pop-Tart or whatnot. It's also important to choose fresh and local foods. And according to, Western's Dining Services Director, she says that there are students who are interested in healthy options and want fresh foods, according to an article written in MLive by Roe 2011. And because of this desire for students to want these healthier options, they are becoming more readily available on campus. Next slide, please. So the other things that you can do are to eliminate stressors, because these do affect your eating patterns. And so ways to do that would be exercising daily at least 30 minutes a day, getting plenty of sleep, at least 7 hours, and also taking breaks when you're studying or doing other activities that are very draining. So today I have told you the different things that are harmful to your eating habits, how they affect you, and what you can do to change it. I want to encourage you to look at your eating habits and to figure out the ways that you can improve them so that you can have a better life now and in the future. Eating habits affect all parts of our life. And as Virginia Woolf once said, who is an English author, one cannot think well, love well, sleep well if one is not dined well. Thank you.